Hello my dear friends, welcome to Niatla Online. Today we are going to learn a simple easier optical map, transposition. Do you know what is transposition? It is the process of converting one form of cylinder into another and is defined as the conversion of a lens power from plus cylinder form to minus cylinder form and minus cylinder form to plus cylinder form without changing its property. There are two types of transposition, simple transposition and the toric transposition. In today's lesson, we are only going to learn about simple transposition. We can discuss toric transposition in another session. The main application of transposition include toric contact lens fitting. It is used in manufacturing unit to find out the base curve. It is also used for selecting tool for surfacing process. As the name suggests, simple transposition is a simple three-step process used to calculate alternative cylinder form. What is the first step? Add sphere and cylindrical power to determine new spherical power. Step 2. Change the sign of cylinder. If the given cylinder is in convex form, we represent a convex lens using plus line. To convert it into concave form, simply change the sign into minus. If the given lens form is concave, change it into convex by changing the sign into plus. Then last step, change the axis by 90 degree. In a cylindrical lens, there are two principal meridian which are 90 degree apart, a axis meridian and a power meridian. If the given lens form have a axis 90 degree or lesser than 90, add 90 degree to find out the axis of transposed to form. If the given axis is greater than 90, deduct 90 degree to find out axis of transposed to form. Let's do some examples. First one, transpose minus 3 diopter sphere with minus 1 diopter cylinder at 90. Here the cylindrical correction is concave form. We have to convert it into convex form by transposing. What is the first step? Add spherical component with cylindrical component. Here the spherical component is minus 3. Add minus 3 with minus 1, that is minus 4 diopter. This is the spherical component of transposed form. Then step 2, change the sign of cylinder. In question, the cylinder is concave. We have to convert it into convex by changing the sign from minus to plus. Here plus 1, this is the cylindrical component of transposed form. The last step, change the axis by 90 degree. Here the axis is 90. When the axis is 90 or lesser than 90, at 90 degree to find out axis of transposed form. Here this is 90, 90 plus 90, that is 180. This is the axis of transposed form. Transposed form of minus 3 diopter sphere with minus 1 diopter cylinder at 90 is minus 4 diopter sphere with plus 1 diopter cylinder at 180. Then example 2, transpose plus 3 diopter sphere with plus 1 diopter cylinder at 180. Here this is convex cylinder form. We have to convert it into concave cylinder form. First step, add plus 3 with plus 1, add sphere with cylinder. That is plus 4. This is the spherical component of transposed form. The step 2, change the sign of cylinder. Here the cylinder is convex. Change it into concave by adding a minus sign. This is the cylindrical component. The last step, change the axis by 90 degree. Here the axis is 180, which is greater than 90. So deduct 90 degree to find out axis of transposed form. 180 minus 90, that is 90. This is the axis of transposed form. Transposed form for plus 3 diopter sphere with plus 1 diopter cylinder at 180 is plus 4 diopter sphere with minus 1 diopter cylinder at 90. Then transpose plus 3 diopter sphere with minus 1 diopter cylinder at 45. Here the spherical component is convex and the cylindrical component is concave. So, signs are different. In this condition, we have to subtract lower digit from greater digit. Here, the greater digit is 3 and lower one is 1. 3 minus 1 is 2 diopter and give the sign of greater digit, that is plus. Plus 2 is the spherical component of transposed form. The step 2, change the sign of cylinder. Here, the cylinder is concave cylinder. We have to convert it into convex by changing the sign into plus. The last step, change the axis. Here, the axis is 45, which is lesser than 90. So, add 90 degree to find out the axis of transposed form. 45 plus 90, that is 135. This is the axis of transposed form. Transposed form of plus 3 diopter sphere with minus 1 diopter cylinder at 45 is plus 2 diopter sphere with plus 1 diopter cylinder at 135. Then example 4, transpose minus 3 diopter sphere with plus 1 diopter cylinder at 45. Here, the spherical component is concave and cylindrical component is convex. In this condition, we have to detect lower digit from greater digits, that is 3 minus 1, 2 diopter, and give the sign of greater digits, that is minus. Minus 2 diopter sphere is the spherical component of transposed form. Then change the sign of cylinder. Here the cylinder is convex, change it into concave by adding a minus sign. Then change the axis by 90 degree. Here the axis is 45, which is lesser than 90. So add 90 degree to find out the axis of transposed form, that is 45 plus 90, 135. This is the axis of transposed form. Transposed form for minus 3 diopter sphere with plus 1 diopter cylinder at 45 is minus 2 diopter sphere with minus 1 diopter cylinder at 135. Then example 5, transpose plus 1 diopter cylinder at 120. Here the spherical component is 0. This is a plano convex cylinder. So we consider spherical component as 0. 0 plus 1 diopter, that is 1 diopter. This is the spherical component of transposed form. Then change the sign. Here the cylindrical sign is plus, that is convex. Convert it into minus concave. Then change the axis by 90 degree. Here the axis is 120, which is greater than 90. So deduct 90 degree from 120, that is 30 degree. This is the axis of transposed form. Transposed form for a plano cylinder plus 1 diopter cylinder at 120 is plus 1 diopter sphere with minus 1 diopter cylinder at 30. The last example, transpose minus 1 diopter spherical with plus 1 diopter cylinder at 180. Here, the spherical component and cylindrical component have same value with opposite sign. Add minus 1 with plus 1, that is 0 diopter. Here, the spherical component is 0. Then change the sign of cylinder. Here, the cylinder is convex. Change it into concave by adding a minus sign. Then change the axis by 90 degree. Here it is now 180. 180 is greater than 90. So detect 90 degree to find out axis of transposed form. Transposed form for minus 1 diopter sphere with plus 1 diopter cylinder at 180 is minus 1 diopter cylinder at 90. This is a plano concave cylinder form. Here is some examples for you. Transpose following powerful alternating form. First one, plus 2 diopter sphere with plus 1, 3 diopter cylinder at 135. Next, minus 1.50 diopter sphere with minus 1 diopter cylinder at 70. Third question, plus 1.50 diopter sphere with minus 1.50 diopter cylinder at 180. Last one, plus 3 diopter sphere with minus 2 diopter cylinder at 90. Please give the answers of above question in comment section. I am waiting for your answer. Thank you. For more videos, please subscribe our channel Niantla Online and put your valuable opinion in comment section.